Saints Row the Third on the PC is a video game featuring provincial characters of the first two game developers created. It sets off throbby noises and epic loud upbeat tracks and fires off with some tunes that could have been dumped into a fiery ocean cove. Nice strict rules of authority, watch out for stagging police officers, they'll capture you in a death sentence. Nice exuberant gameplay, very lifestyle, you can choose from. No matter if you're a chick or a German robot or a male blow-up doll, whatever you want, this game has pretty much the basic comedy terms and what the F randomness in your delivered arms. Nobody's patient in this game. The AI can hook into terrible misleading directions. The gears, in fact, is the best vehicles, mods, or whatever desire you choose from. It's heavily balanced, nice marathon missions. It may go bonkers in a way, but it's smirked to some and follows the party animal's route. This is a bit boring suck-faced mess, but speaking of suck-faces, the game is halfway entertaining. Don't get me wrong, most of the missions suck and are terrible letdowns. Then a hand of glasses up your ass containing something fun. The taste is hard to describe. It's not sexual, neither is cough syrup of entertainment. The word I'm looking for is stale, repetitive. It's like a lot of missions make you do the same thing over and over again. Destroy tanks, destroy mercenaries. Okay, buddies, we get the point. How about a mission where we can throw a teddy bear in the air and explode his head off terminally? The enemies are amongst in the game and are terribly scared in the skimpy talking, and the cell phone menu is a battery garbage takeaway attack that's both untechnical and the ground gives me the boogie feelings of nastiness. Collecting collectibles can be reframed, difficulty finding them if you want to complete the game 100%. I still go 25% to go in order to beat the game fully, but the main game takes you about 13-15 hours the most I've got from this game. That's my only gripe with the halfway part of the game. It's funny the ending is similar to the end deals with Star Wars, not telling you more, got found out yourself. I greatly back to the sparkliness the buildings and textures have. Some really are a pain to look at, but you can get lost in the game for many hours. You just have to have an open mind and explore the advanced locations around the selective world. The length of effects are crazy to look at, and they know how to promote a smart world of a game, but down in the levels where the community's at, you can't really enter locations, which is a huge letdown. But enough of me complaining, what do I give this game? I give this game a 9.5/10. 5 points off is right. The game is satisfaction, like the song from Bay Benassi, but the cutscenes are survey boring. It pumps fluid to a lot of sparks. I do love the sexuality in this game more than another GTA spins off. A revealer mouth to most, but sometimes blending magic into an uproar world can notice the free flaws, and that's why we need reviewers to point those out. Love the Burrito Master.